makes its way there. And now the six are set. Ready. They're off and racing. The rank outsider, Golden Rack, first of them to jump, but now the favourite drives through, Rockanori. Going up is Selavachi as well. Factory Made had settled in fourth spot, just in front there of Black Fantasy. And out the back in the early stages is the Great Southerner, Karamundi. Out to the 1,000 they go. Parnham held the front with Rockanori. And this lightly raced colt leads the way. Rockanori, three quarters of a length, now a length clear from Golden Rack. Factory Made third down on the inside. And he's getting it cheaply, Rockanori. Selavachi is up there travelling fourth, followed on the rails by Karamundi, and dropping out last in this field of six is Black Fantasy, and is spotting the fave about four and a half as they come along to the 600. Rockanori making play and well held. Leads Golden Rack three quarters. Selavachi peeling off its back, going up there three deep prior to the home turn. Over on the inside, Factory Made, and then further back behind those came Karamundi, and to the extreme outside is Black Fantasy, who's going to be forced out four deep at the top of the straight. Parnham's about to get to work on Rockanori. The favourite didn't make the turn all that well. He wobbled out. He's near the middle of the track from Golden Rack. Factory Made. Black Fantasy down the outside, but Rockanori with a handy lead past the 100 clear. Driving up near the inside is Karamundi. Black Fantasy runs on, but Rockanori, he did it well enough in front. He makes it two for two. Wins at Rockanori from Black Fantasy and Karamundi. Factory Made fourth home, followed by Selavachi, who compounded, and likewise Golden Rack. So Rockanori was able to just dictate and please itself pretty much. Chris kicking him on the turn, and the colt just wobbled off a little when they get out there with this rail at 15. He's run 124 and a half at a controlled tempo all of the way and keeps the record unblemished, beating two Black Fantasy, five Karamundi and three Factory Made. So those are the numbers. It's 4, 2, 5 and 3. Selavachi beaten off, a bit disappointing. Rockanori for Grant Williams by Awesome Rock out of Nishikawa. Chris Parnham here in the saddle for Madame's Pinabahaja McLernan. Also Ralston and Davidson, Chalwell, Fitzgerald, Sherry, Starkey, Nisbet, Young, Warburton, Banks and Williams, along also with the Unger Family Syndicate. And it's two for two over number two. Black Fantasy by Blackfriars out of Dream Along, Dan and Ben Pierce. Joe has a party, and five Karamundi by Playing God from Pins, perhaps. Steve Wolfe, Sean McGruddy. Task Made tough there for Black Fantasy. Back last, the way it was a stack and rack affair, and then forced four deep to try and make ground on Rockanori. Unable to do that. 4, 2, 5 and 3. Margins, a length and a half ahead, and it's 35.08, the last 600. Race 2, the Tab Touch Better Your Bet Maiden. It's over the 1600, the next on the card, a field of eight to do battle on this occasion. We're about to go down now to the yard. Once again, we'll catch up with Brittany, who'll be with us in any tick of the clock. In fact, we can go there right now. Britt.
Yeah, thanks, Darren. Obviously, Grant Williams still at the Magic Millions sale complex, as will be a lot of the trainers, I think, today as the sale does wrap up in the early stages of this afternoon. But Rockanori, Scott, a good performance and remains undefeated at both trials and races. He came onto the scene winning that maiden a fortnight or so ago, and that flashed plenty of potential, and he's delivered on it again today.
Certainly does. Brittany, there's an options now for them. Where do they start to chime in if they do intend to try and get him to the Derby? When do they try and chime into that series? Is it next start at the 1800 of the JC Roberts, which is a fortnight from this Saturday? Quite possibly, but I certainly like the way that he wobbled around the corner, didn't handle it, as Darren said, and he's called that well, yet he was still able to balance up very quickly, put them away, and he was holding them all through the line. Black Fantasy loses no admirers there. There's a win round, just around the corner, and Kuramundi, it's a big step from a maiden down at Albany to a three-year-old midweeker. He's definitely going to measure up as well.
All right, Rockanori takes out the first at Ascot. We'll be back for the second.